हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम डॉक्टर आशीष आहूजा, अ ट्रेन्ड विट्रो रेटिना स्पेशलिस्ट, एंड इन टुडेज वीडियो वील बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट मैक्यूलर होल्स एंड इट्स मैनेजमेंट। मैक्यूलर होल इज अ टर्म दैट हैज बीन यूज्ड टू डिस्क्राइब सेवरल क्लिनिकल एंड हिस्टोपैथोलॉजिकली डिस्टिंक्ट एंटिटीज इन विच देर कुड बी माइनर डिस्टर्बेंसेज टू अ फुल थिकनेस डिफेक्ट इन द न्यूरोसेंसरी रेटिना। सो इन दिस इमेज यू कैन सी देर इज अ राउंड neurosensory defect in the macular area, which is the main area which gives us vision. So the frequency is it is usually idiopathic and incidence increases with age, and it affects approximately 3 in 1,000 individuals, and peak incidence is in about 7 decades of life, and women are more predisposed compared to men. So patients usually present with complaints of blurred vision, metamorphopsia, distortion while seeing in the central gaze. A large macular hole may produce a central scotoma, a dark black spot in front of the vision. Some patients may also be asymptomatic when diagnosed with macular holes, usually when they are at initial stage of presentation. Patients with small eccentric holes may present with a good visual acuity of 20 by 25 to 20 by 40, but patients in which who have a large full thickness macular holes and slightly chronic holes will have a poorer visual acuity, which will range from 20 by 80 to 20 by 400. So the etiology is idiopathic in most cases. There is no cause which is found, but there are certain cases where there are secondary causes which are noted. For example, in cases of trauma or pathological myopias, or in cases where a laser photocoagulation has been done to the retina, cases of best disease, and as a side effect of certain drugs as well. So pathophysiology of macular holes include there is a focal shrinkage of the prefoveal vitreous cortex, which has been documented, and then there's a tangential traction on the surface of the retina, which causes stretching of the photoreceptors and other layers, which leads to a full thickness defect in the macular area. So the most widely followed classification is by GAS, which divides macular holes into 4 stages. Stage 1A includes an impending macular hole, which appears as a yellow spot. It measures about 100 to 200 microns in size. And as the disease progresses, the stage which is progressed to is stage 1B, which is called as yellow spot. And the size of the defect increases to about 200 to 300 microns at this stage, and the vision also deteriorates further. As the disease progresses, you can see in the image, the center of the yellow ring appears reddish, and the yellow ring itself develops irregular edges. Stage 2 is an early full thickness macular hole. The hole becomes evident in 2 ways, and more often it appears as eccentric, caused by separation of the prefoveolar cortex from one edge of the hole, and then spontaneous vitrofoveolar separation occurs, creating a semi-transparent opacity, the pseudo-operculum, which often enlarges, and then the underlying occult macular hole becomes visible. As disease progresses, the yellow ring disappears because of the relief of the prefoveolar traction on the edge of the occult macular hole. Stage 3 macular hole is a full thickness macular hole without a posterior vitreous detachment. The vitreous is still attached to the foveal area. It takes about 3 to 6 months to develop, and the central defect increases to more than 400 microns. A stage 4 macular hole is a full thickness macular hole where the posterior vitreous detachment has developed, and usually patients are symptomatic at this stage. As seen in the image, you can see a very well demarcated round macular hole which is seen, and usually we pick this up on clinical examination, slit lamp examination with contact lenses or wide angle lenses which we use can easily pick up these macular holes. And the important test which has to be done includes an optical coherence tomography, The OCT test gives us the exact dimensions of the hole. The base diameter is an important parameter to note. The holes which are larger than 600 microns are usually called large macular holes, and the prognosis and the surgery also becomes more challenging, and at times these patients may require multiple surgeries to close their macular holes. Another important test clinically where we can, you know, pick up the progression of the disease is use of Amsler's grid test. The differential diagnosis for macular hole includes an epiretinal membrane with a pseudo hole, macular cyst, vitromacular traction. These diseases can be easily differentiated on clinical examination and with the use of OCT. So an epiretinal membrane is a condition where a thin layer is formed in front of the retina, and it will cause stretching of the nerve fiber and the neurosensory retina, and it will lead to a partial thickness defect. And those patients will also present with distortion of vision, and which is metamorphopsia and reduced central visual acuity. In certain cases, there might be a spontaneous arrest and closure of macular holes. This is usually seen in stage 1A or 1B holes, where there is a vitreous separation and the holes may spontaneously close. Now, the fellow eyes also have a risk of macular holes developing, and the incidence is about 10% in patients without PVD. So the treatment is mainly surgical. Patients who are diagnosed to have macular holes are advised surgery, and the sooner a patient is operated, the better chances of the macular hole closing, and better is the gain in visual acuity post-surgery, which usually is about 1 to 2 lines gain in distant visual acuity. And so the pre-surgery visual acuity is the most important prognostic factor, and also the base diameter of the macular hole, which will determine the final visual outcome. So presently the anatomic success after a macular hole surgery is quite good, and it ranges from about 80 to 100%. So the basic steps of the surgery include making a 3-port pars plana vitrectomy incision, and we'll be discussing with this surgical video. So this is a 2nd port which is being constructed. This is a 25 gauge pars plana vitrectomy. Inferotemporal area is where our infusion is, which will maintain the intraocular pressure as we are performing the surgery. So one entry point is for the illumination. The 2nd entry into the eye is where we insert the vitrectomy cutter that is used to clear the vitreous gel from the eye. So here we are performing a core vitrectomy. We are clearing the central vitreous. This is an important step where we are debulking the vitreous cavity. So when we enter the vitreous cavity, as a principle, we have to clear as much of the vitreous as possible. So we are using 5,000 cuts per minute in this procedure, and for better vitreous clearance, we can use different staining techniques. Here we are using triamcinolone acetonide to stain the vitreous, and posterior vitreous detachment is being So the main management of macular hole include surgical intervention. What we do is we perform a pars plana vitrectomy, clear 3 ports inside the eye, and clear the vitreous cavity, then do an internal limiting membrane peeling. Around the macular hole area, we relieve the traction which is developed, which is causing the macular hole to form and increase in size over time. So, and at the end, we use a fluid air exchange and close the eye under air tamponade, or at times we might use sulfur hexafluoride or C3F8 gas. Patients are usually required to maintain a strict face down position after the surgery. Prone position is required to be maintained for about 4 to 10 days after the surgery. That is important for the surgical success. Thank you.